her the sanest, the smartest, the nicest woman that has ever come aboard this ship.
Anything else?
Anything else, sir? I'll keep to myself for the moment.
Another thing in terms of a love story, I did one with Scotty in a show called Lights of Zetar.
I didn't think Mr. Scott would go for the brainy type.
I don't think he's even noticed she has a brain.
And the problem you have with that is if you have a subsidiary, any of the main three characters of Kirk, Spock, and McCoy in love, you have to do that without diminishing the roles of your three principals. So you have those kind of problems going for you.
Mr. Scott? Mr. Scott?
Hmm? The leading man can be a most interesting character. Of course, it has to be written that way. The leading man, the hero, as against the leading man, the hero has to be on the horns of a dilemma all the time. He has to be making, should I go left or should I go right? And then the story tells you why everybody thinks he should go left and why everybody thinks he should go right. And then something inside him or some external incident makes him go in a third direction. And that's the essence of a story of that kind. And so playing that can be really interesting for an actor, whether it's Hamlet or whether it's, Captain Kirk.